When a hippo opens its mouth this wide, it's not because it had a late night in the swamp, it's a deadly warning. Mostly they use this tactic in disputes over territorial waters. But in recent decades, there have been reports of hippos using those powerful jaws and pointy teeth to eat flesh. What's going on with this giant plant eater? Do hippopotamuses really practice carnivory? And could this behavior be killing them? The Okavango Delta has the third largest population of hippos in Africa. Despite its larger-than-life presence, the hippopotamus amphibious, or river horse, is difficult to study. They are extremely dangerous and almost impossible to track. Every year, scientists uncover surprising, even shocking new facts about their lives. A less surprising fact may be that liking, subscribing, and clicking the bell helps our channel grow, so thanks a lot for doing so. It might look like there are plenty of territorial waters for these hippopots. But after consulting aerial surveys of the Okavango population for over 13 years, researchers have discovered they are picky about their homes. They need the right water depth. Swamps are too shallow, main channels too deep. Because when hippos are in deep water, they are literally in deep water. On the surface, they glide gracefully at around 8 kilometers per hour, but they are not swimming. Hippos actually walk through water, springing like astronauts in zero gravity. They are sinkers, not floaters, because they have extremely dense bones. And, surprisingly, they carry very little body fat. Fat which would help them stay on the surface. So, for this giant, deep water is out of the question, which makes the perfect hippo depth waterhole highly contested, and hippos extremely territorial. But how do they know when an outsider enters their territory? Another study has found that hippos can tell family from strangers just by listening to their voices. At close quarters, a hippo can use its gape to grab the head of its opponent and throw it off balance. These giants are the real jaws of the animal kingdom. Hippos can open their mouths almost 180 degrees. That's 30 degrees more than a great white shark is capable of. And those ferocious teeth. Both canines and incisors grow up to 50 centimeters long in an adult male. But hippos pay a price for big choppers. They can't chew as efficiently as other herbivores. Their jaws won't move from side to side because their teeth interlock. The hippopotamus may have traded the joys of normal chewing to scare off trespassers, and not just other hippos. Whoever enters their territory, including humans, risks being attacked. Their teeth have another downside. They are classified as ivory. Since the international ban on the elephant ivory trade, poachers are now targeting the hippo. Hippopotamuses have become rarer than the African elephant. As long as there is water, the Okavango Delta's population is safe. But when rainfall stops and severe droughts prevail, they are forced to find new places to survive. A group of hippos are on the move, galloping through the swamps, bulldozing pathways for other animals to use. A group of lions take advantage. There's a straggler. The hippo seems to be trapped, but it can easily defend itself against a hungry lion. Hippos have been known to bite a lion's head off. A group of lions is another matter. But this hippopotamus is fearless, unpredictable, and angry. If they want to emerge from this confrontation unscathed, the lions must back off. Adult hippos have no big predators. They may be the real predators. It has been known for a long time that hippos, on rare occasions, will eat meat. It's not unusual for herbivores to eat meat or bones in times of drought, when vegetation is hard to find. But over the last decade, incidences of hippo carnivory have been witnessed in bad and good seasons. They are eating a lot more meat than previously thought. And this diet could be killing hippos by making them highly susceptible to a deadly bacterial disease, anthrax. Compared to other large herbivores like buffalo and elephants, hippos can die in alarmingly high numbers during an anthrax outbreak. Some scientists say this may be due in part to their scavenging ways. During outbreaks, hippos have been seen feeding on anthrax-infected animal carcasses, including members of their own pods. Humans who eat hippo meat also risk death. Anthrax outbreaks often happen in times of drought, when hippos must cram into diminishing water holes. This deadly situation will become more common as our climate changes. For now, in the Okavango Delta, there is enough water. But the climate can be just as unpredictable as an angry hippo. Thanks for watching. Please consider subscribing for more amazing wildlife content and hit the alert button so you don't miss our next upload.